Titans have green action. First 2 out of 3 falls, 30-minute time limit, with a combined weight of 501 pounds. First ball, the pride of St. Louis, Reichman, Keith Parsons. And Gonzalez, 265 pounds, the very capable teammate, Lance Bennett. Their opponent this evening from Atlanta, combined weight 514 pounds, the fabulous Freebird, Buddy Roberts, and his tag team partner, Michael Hayes. Rick has it, your referee.
All right, as Joe said, TV man is on end of action now, tag team action, Lance and Reichman against Hayes and Roberts. Best 2 of 3 falls, 30-minute time limit. Michael Hayes up on the ropes here, right above my head. They are really riding high tonight, boasting those new belts. There's Michael leaping back down. Well, Lance representing the Montana family tonight here, giving a nice man King Tyson. Boy, what a night we have. So many questions answered for the first time in really a long, long time without the missing race. People have wondered, hey, what is the deal with this guy? The painted face, the strange behavior, can he talk? Well, we've had some really important questions answered for you. That is so sound. Boy, Lance means business, doesn't it? Remember, Lance will be teaming with Kevin and Terry when he had this World 6-Man title rematch on the 27th. That was not a tag, that was just 0-5. Benny Robertson last night. Referee stance. Terry Jones, the Roberts committee, not Lance. That's not a call to that end. And Roberts is doing anything but. Remember, Roberts already a big winner tonight, pocketing $3,000 in the television bet. Also tonight, we've seen the very surprising and unpredictable and apparent breakup of the dynamic duo, which has first led to a showdown bout that Gino doesn't even know about yet. Adam Chase climbed it to make Gino pay. Well, geez, the mental battle for Puerto Rico have gotten out of hand, and you know what that means. Lance has the leg scissors around Buddy Roberts, and it's Payne City. Hayes a little anxious on his side of the ring. Speaking of Egos, Percy Fingers Egos and Bruce for the missing link, and Percy, Reed, and the link are going to have continued problems. With a tie-up for Freebird, Michael Hayes. Well, we're really lucky to get to see this main event as our TV main tonight. Boy, last week, you know, you remember back, it was supposed to be Reed and Reichman. In fact, they were already in the ring. Look at Hayes here. Now he's moonwalking. Anyway, they got sent to the back after the interview session that led to an altercation in the back, and the tag bout came out with Terry and Brody against the Gang and Brody. We went off the air about that time, as you saw when we opened tonight, with Brody singing the thing. The bout after that was sensational. Then, when that bout was over, Reed and Reichman came back to their rematch. Look at Lance here, the red scissors around Hayes, who finally kicked up, and backed away yelling at Rick Hazard. Well, Iceman wound up winning the bout, but when it was over, Tracy got in the ring, hit Iceman with a cane, and the two, Reed and Tracy, proceeded to beat Iceman to a pulp. What a night we had last week, and it's certainly not to be the same way tonight. We've already seen it get out of hand with Christian Juma. Lance from McAlee. Lance adapting more to this high flying Von Erich, not only fast, but extremely strength-oriented style of wrestling in the Von Erich is combining strength with speed. A style seen nowhere else in the world. Let's now twisting that arm of Fredo McAlee. When you talk Fredo, you're talking the best. They've been around the world and they've faced the best, much like the Von Erich. Fredo's involved in one of the biggest cards we've ever seen at Comiskey Park last summer. Over and down goes Michael. Another lamp. Michael now puts him back. Good luck to have one that knocks him back. Freebird's involved in one of the biggest cards the world has ever seen at Texas Stadium. Right in the turnbuckle.
5 minutes.
Head again on this turnbuckle. Lance now back inside. Blocking encouragement to Freebird Hayes. Iceman anxiously wants in. It's been all Lance so far for that team. Gets your record salary ticket all rainbow ticket match outlets. Unless you can be with us Monday night or Friday or next Friday before the tour, and you can get those first seats for every in-person fan when you're there. Elbow by Hayes. And down goes Roddick. Remember, you need to be with us Monday night, not only to get your seats, but to see the great tide, the last until the 27th. We're back for a week here in Fort Worth on Monday the 20th. It'll be your last chance for 3 weeks to see action. Actually, 2 weeks to see action. Well, it's getting charged here. Back up and continuing to miss out the punishment. Down he goes. Lance really putting on a display. The future for this guy is so exciting that it's difficult to capture him. I'm really excited about that main event Monday night at the Bill Rocky Exhibit Hall, the inside building. Over down goes Roberts, Lance remains in charge. As the Gordian Hayes against Terry and Greaser Brody, Monday night. Now here's Michael Hayes up yelling at the fans, frustrated at Lance's success here. Lance backing over, turns the Iceman for the first time in this bout. Betty's been in a while. Headbutt. Buddy on the seat of his pants. Buddy, the six-man winner the other night. TV winner tonight. The tag now, here comes Michael Hayes. Tall, lanky, and very strong, and very, very smart. Iceman trying to knock his brains out. And to the floor, he goes. Michael Hayes trying to shake it off on the floor, complaining to Rick Hazard about the alleged use of the fist. Before I forget, next week, you folks in Decatur, Naples, and Greenville, you're ready to be with us to hear about exciting world-class fundraising cards coming to your community. As world-class Western continues to be the number one fundraiser for nonprofit organizations, as the Cotter JCs will tell you, we were in Cotter last week, a great card and a tremendous crowd raising a big amount of money for their charity. Hayes and the Iceman lock it up. Hayes knocks into the corner. Coming up yet tonight, our tape feature, the dynamic duo against the Cosmo Cowboys. You can see what started the problems that we saw tonight between Gino and Chris. We have yet to talk to Percy and Reed. We have Chris Adams and Brian Anderson about. Chris Reed and the missing link. So really, we're just getting going. Here's Hayes all over the place. Here's the tag to Buddy Roberts. And in he comes. Davidson Sports, world-class wrestling on Channel 11, coming to you in stereo from Fort Worth. There's a drive by Roberts. Nice man in the middle. Great turn. Grabs the foot. Iceman with a smile. Sends him around. Franklin Lance, Lance is flying high. Down, right on top of the head with the elbow.
10 minutes.
Lance becoming more and more exciting. Using more and more moves, exercising more and more options in the ring. Back into the rope. And through the ropes and to the floor on the near side of the ring. Roberts. Here's a tag for Michael Hayes now. Made play the Freebird as Hayes picks Lance up. Lance being punished now by Michael Hayes. Into the mat goes the head. Hayes again, clearly slamming that head. You can see it. Hayes pulls him out. Good, comes straight down head first. Lance may be hurt. Michael Hayes with a dirty move. Throws him into the foot of Buddy Roberts, and we are seeing the Freebirds at their best. Which is the worst? Buddy gets thrown. Tried to push Lance over. Lance throws forward. Driving into the corner. Tags the Iceman, and here they go with the first strike. Roberts thrown over and down. But Roberts does just the right thing at the right time. Look at the Freebird. Roberts tried to make a turn, but Michael did. Iceman gives him the hip butt and gets a one close ring victory. And look at Michael Hayes. Michael doesn't know what happened.
The winners of the first fall, the team of Lance Van Eerth and the Iceman team, Tyson.
Credit to the Iceman. Roberts tried to do just what Michael did, and it backfired. That's when the Iceman are up 1-0. We'll be back for our second fall from Will Adams, Tennessee, and for those of you watching World Class Wrestling on Championship Sports in Ferry. Behind and Sunshine will be in their corner. Freebird Terry Gordy goes against the Iceman. Lance faces Gino. This is Jack Victor, Tommy Montana. A big night. Friday night in Dallas will have Wrestling Star Wars service for you. And you're with us that night. Hayes and Kevin plus much more Friday night in Big D. Now let's go back to the ring. Iceman has found a loving fan back here. Iceman calling back. That lady hadn't been that excited in years. Buddy Roberts, the Iceman. He's the one laughing back there, right in the middle of your picture with a hand in the air. Well, that's my getting the duck in Oklahoma. Next week, you folks in the Santa Nerds want to be on hand, all your size to be there. Iceman with a choker on Buddy Roberts. Iceman here with lots of Bud Roberts to wave, and here's the tag for Michael. Look out, Michael, coming from above. Michael now all over the place. Michael stomping the Iceman unmercifully. Now Michael is his choking person. Michael is not interested in anything the referee or the fans have to say. Freebird must win this fall to force the third in the siding fall. Hayes transferring over elegantly. Hayes now from behind, grabbing the Iceman. Hits him up. Hits him over the way, brings his face to get into a man's back that way. But Hayes, believe me, doesn't care. And now he's shoving Rick Hazard around. Here's the tag team, Buddy Roberts. We're in our second fall. Roberts throws Iceman to the floor, and Hayes threatens to go over, and Lance comes that way. Lance having Iceman back up. Iceman there to be kicked by Buddy Roberts as he tries to get back in. Again, with the Iceman. And Roberts is there to pick up the action again. Roberts down in the spot, and look at Buddy shooting his face. Fans are doing the thing there. Iceman driven into the knee, a tag for Hayes. Looks like a suplex, or is it? Hayes can't get the leverage. I know he's strong, but he can't get the leverage. And the Iceman throws him over, and Michael hits on his head. Iceman stood far enough away from Michael that Hayes couldn't get the leverage for the suplex, and Iceman threw him over. Each man wanted to tag his teammate. Iceman just now getting up. But he did get to Lance. Lance all over Roberts in the corner. 5 minutes. 5 minutes is going by the second ball. As Lance throws Roberts over, goes right back over to grab him. Lance goes in that side again. Comes back with an elbow. Lance stops as he sees Hayes coming in and knocks him back into the corner. Here's Iceman over to keep Roberts away. All four men involved. A four-way in the ring here. Hayes gets thrown into Roberts' back. And pulls him back out with a slam. all four men involved. Lance on Haney. Iceman on Roberts. Elbow by Lance. Haney goes down. Wait a minute. Here comes Terry Gordy. Terry Gordy took the lead and Lance dropped 16 away. Gordy holding on. Gordy has hit the ring. It may be 3-on-2. Roberts throws the Iceman away. And Gordy has the only other spike on Lance Von Erich. Gordy with the spike on Lance, and this is getting dangerous. I think the Freebirds are trying to injure Lance when Kevin and Terry are not in the building. The Oriental spike, and look at Hayes throw. Rick Hazard away. Hayes doing everything to keep Gordy on top of Lance. This is an obvious attempt here to injure Lance Von Erich before the sixth man of the convention center. Knowing that Kevin and Terry aren't here, the Freebirds stooping to new lows. I hope Lance is not hurt by this dangerous Oriental spike. Tommy Montana out and thrown away. All the way to the floor. Lance in grave danger here. Roberts nailing Rick Hazard. Lance set on the spike. The Freebirds trying to take Lance out. Not only of the bout coming up, but maybe period. Brian Abiasad with several clean shots on Gordy to get him away. I hope Lance is all right. This has been a scary and deliberate attempt by the fabulous Freebirds. We'll be back in just a moment from Freebirds.